This is how to make this trending 2.5D parallax image effect in After Effects. So start by creating a Photoshop project and use your desired resolution. Now import the image and scale it up so it fits inside the frame. To create the parallax effect, we need to isolate each object on the image on a single layer. Since I have a foreground, a person and a background, I will duplicate the image 3 times by pressing Ctrl and J. On the top layer, select your first object using the selection tool, and you can press W to select it. Once you're happy with the selection, you can create a mask for the object. If you hold Alt and then left click on the eye icon, we can isolate the layer and see only our mask. Now isolate the second layer by Alt clicking and then create a selection for your second object, and then create a mask for it again. And it doesn't matter in which order you do this. And you can of course also use the brush tool to adjust the mask a bit. Now on top of the background layer, you need to create a new layer to remove the objects. And on that layer, you want to remove the objects completely. You can use generative fill or the remove tool for this. And you can select the remove tool by pressing J or Shift J to switch through the different tools. And then you can simply remove the objects from the image, so we only get the background. Then select the background layer and the object removed layer that we created, then right click and select convert to smart object to make it one layer. Once you're done isolating your objects, go to file, save as, and then save it somewhere easy. And then you can close Photoshop. Now open After Effects and then drag your Photoshop project inside it. And make sure the import kind is set to composition and editable layer styles is checked, and then press OK. Now drag the comp to your main composition and then double click to open it. In here you can see all your Photoshop layers. Now to create the parallax effect, you need to make all your layers 3D by pressing on this icon. And then create a camera by right clicking new and then camera, and then you can use the default settings. And to explain and show what I'm doing, I'm going to enable the top down view, but you don't have to do this. Now select all your Photoshop layers and then press P for position. And then change the third position value, which is the Z axis, to move it back in space. And do this for your background layer first. And you can see on the top down view that we are moving it back. And you can move it back to around 1000. And then do the same with the next layer. Move it back a bit, but don't move it further than the background layer. Keep some distance to it. And you can see it more clearly on the top down view. And for the foreground rocks, you don't want to move it further than the person or object that you have, so have some space between them as well. And you can now disable top down view if you enabled it. Now select your layers and press S for scale, and then simply scale them up so they cover the screen like the original image. If you have a person or an object that you want to animate, then you can select the layer and on the top left select the puppet tool. Then you can create some points that you can control. To animate these points, make sure you're at the start of the clip, and then you can hold Ctrl by dragging a point to create a small animation. And you can of course also keyframe them manually instead. And you can smoothen out the animation by pressing U to expand the layer, and then hold Alt and left click on the pin with the keyframes on it. And in this expression, you can simply type out smooth, open bracket, and then close bracket. And we now have this small movement on the person. Now to create the zoom for the parallax effect, select the camera layer and then make sure you're at the start of clip, and then press P for position. And create a keyframe for position, move to the end of the layer, and then increase the third position value. And this is how it looks. And you can of course also reverse the keyframes and make it zoom out instead, if you prefer that.